Very good morning to all my dear students. Welcome you all again to a class of English. And today we'll discuss about the chapter, The 100 Dresses, Part 2. In continuation of the previous lesson, The 100 Dresses reveals why Wanda Petronsky had not been coming to school. The Petronsky family decided to move to a big city where no one would care about their unfamiliar name. On hearing the note, Maddie and Peggy got anxious as they realized that they would never get a chance for making amends for all the teasing they have done to Wanda Petronsky, either for her dresses or for her funny name. Both the girls get relieved only learning that Wanda liked them and had dedicated one of the 100 dresses to each one of them. So, the lesson begins with all the students of room number 13 having a look at the wonderful drawings of Wanda Petronsky. Only then a note is received by Miss Masson from Wanda's father informing that one of his two children will attend the school as they are moving to a big city where no one would judge them for their names. Miss Masson was felt shocked and conveyed her disappointment to the class. Maddie was affected by this letter of Wanda's father. She instantly developed an urge to apologize to Wanda. Peggy and Maddie, the two best friends, rushed to Boggin Heights, hoping that the family hadn't moved yet. But to their dismay, to their depression, the family had already moved and there was no sign of life in and around the house. Maddie lost her sleep thinking, when a coward she is and what a coward she is who couldn't stand against the wrong. That day she decided that she will never let anyone tease someone like that again. That weekend, Peggy and Maddie decided to write a letter to Wanda that was originally meant to be apologetic, but they ended up writing a friendly note asking her how did she like the new place. Weeks passed by and there was no reply until she heard from Wanda. In this letter, Wanda wrote she misses everyone and conveyed the intention of gifting one dress each to Maddie and Peggy because she has a whole new lot of 100 dresses lined up in her new house. Both of them were happy to receive it and later realized that it was their faces she had drawn along with the dresses. Thus, they both concluded that Wanda liked them. So, as Wanda's father came to know about the bad behavior that she had been saving in the school, that Wanda's family decided to move to a different city because in a big city there were many Polish immigrants. So the natives would not find them strange and would not make fun of them. Wanda and her brother Jake could attend school without feeling bad. And yes, life in a big city would be different for the family because there would be more people of their community over there. They would feel live comfortable there. And the best part is that Mary and Peggy had realized their mistake of teasing Wanda because of her poverty as well as because of her funny name. And she too was a part of it. As Mary was also a part of it, she remained silent and let Peggy tease Wanda, even knowing the fact that she herself belonged to a poor family and she herself worn the handout clothes that were handed over to her by others. So this story really left us means overwhelmed and moved us a lot, because when we realized that how strong Wanda would be, that she all tolerated all these things and never reacted, just answering the questions that have been asked by either Peggy or Maddie or the other girls of the school. So at the same time, she teaches us a very important message that we should never react to the situation, rather face it by keeping us calm and composed. And at the last, this story also teaches us that we should have the tendency to forgive others for their mistakes. So now in the next class, we'll discuss more about the second part and we'll have an explanation of the chapter in detail.